Wini-welcome si Pastor Leo para sa kanyang panalangin.
Sige po, sa magandang hapon po. Aming Diyos, patuloy po kami nagpapasalamat sa patuloy mo pag-abot sa pangangailangan ng bawat isa. Salamat Panginoon sa programang ito na umabot po sa pangangailangan ng mga ina. Tumatala kayo Diyos sa mga alalahanin nila, sa mga bagay na kanila pong iniisip. Salamat Panginoon sa pagbibigay ng pagkakataon upang mabigyan ng liwanag ang bawat ina, ang bawat kababaihan, para buuin kanilang mapalakas ang bawat isa sa pamamagitan ng pagtalakay na ito. Amin nga pong in-acknowledge Lord ang iyo pong kapangyarihan na kung wala ka, wala.
Abangan! Ngayong March 29, 2018, mula alas 7 ng umaga hanggang alas 12 ng tanghali, ang espesyal na programa tungkol sa mga tradisyon at paniniwala ngayong Semana Santa, dito lang sa 1116 DXAS, your community radio.
This is your community radio, 1116 DXAS, communicating Christ in our world.
Our time is around 3:03 in the afternoon.
Hello, health? Bakit kaya pabalik-balik at palaging nagkakasakit ang anak ko?
Hello, help. Bakit ba kahit anong pagsusumikap ko ay kulang na kulang pa rin ang kita? Tuloy, kapos palagi.
Solusyon sa problema.
Sagot sa mga tanong.
Hatid ay edukasyon sa kalusugan at kabuhayan. Hello, help. Kaagapay sa malusog.
At maginhawang buhay.
Hello, help!
Buenas, 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 buenas tardes a todos! Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Maayong hapon sa tanan. Assalamualaikum kaniyo katan. How are you doing, my dear friends, and how is your day today? We hope that you are not only enjoying every bit of it, but you find it to be more meaningful and beautiful. Live life like never before, day by day. Welcome everyone to our fifth episode of our radio program on health education, life coaching, learning opportunities towards holistic empowerment and livelihood program. In short, it's Hello Health po tayo dyan. On this 24th day of March, year 2018, we are bringing you valuable information regarding our Hello Help updates. We have now reached our first month as a new radio program and thank you for listening avidly. Happy Mansari po para sa lahat. My name is Alain A. Paragas and with me is my ever-supportive, caring, and dynamic partner in the program and advocacy, Mr. Jason C. Mahinay, the Municipal Link and Chairman of Pantawid Pamilyang Pilipino Program of DSWD Mabuhay. Hello and good afternoon to you, partner.
Yes, partner. Good afternoon to you.
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing great. Pero grabe kanina yung traffic. Pero
kung makating
dito,
talagang
hindi ko ma-carry yung traffic. Talagang haba talaga. And isa pa doon, no? Talagang nahirapan ako kanina for submissions
kasi,
of mga reports natin.
Oo, graduating na yun. Yes. Alam mo na, ending of the month of March.
Kaya nga patapos na. Kaya talagang...
congratulations to survive mo.
Survive naman so
and,
far.
And we would also like to say congratulations ulit sa atin kasi dumating na tayo ng isang buwan.
Correct, partner.
Happy month rin nga
Yes.
Okay. So, partner Jay, we are very fortunate and happy to have here with us yung sinasabi natin last week.
Yes.
Two of our valuable and important guests for this
Correct.
Afternoon. I said valuable,
very, yes.
Very fortunate tayo dahil on our first month anniversary, talagang pinagbigyan tayo.
Correct.
Okay. So before we get to know them, allow me to greet our friends and were tuning into our radio program. So we say hi and hello to my dear family and relatives there in Talon-Talon for actively listening, most especially to my mom and my dad who are our number one fan.
Wow.
Of course, warm greetings po sa ating mga correspondent leaders in the field, sina Dubli Alibasa, mm-hmm, all the way from Cotabato, and then si Mukhtar Azmat there, and si Sultan Jubair Muhammad, actually yung leader natin sa Holo.
Sa Holo, sir.
And then si Papa Mike, sina Brother Abs Alvarez, sina Ustad Saukani Kimpa,
wow,
yung anak niya si Sir Hussein Kimpa.
Good afternoon.
Yes, si PO2 Judy Jayari na nakikinig din po. Mm-hmm. And then si Sir Timhar Ismael would like to say hi, hello and hello to Sir Rapi Tayo and the ever-supportive group of Kiblat Sin Jantung and the Kabalikat Team Passport 4 Group and to our good partners in your area partner
from Mabuhay,
ayun, including in Holo and Tawi-Tawi. I will be coming back for the training on this coming April 3 to 6. Talagang pinagdidibdiban na to, partner.
Yes.
Talagang hindi napaawat ang advocacy natin.
Okay. Inahanap ka na.
How about you, partner? Would you like to
greet some
of our friends? Yes, of course,
partner Allen. I would like also to say hi and good afternoon to dear friends, Zimosa dyan, of course, na nagiginig. Raking Honey Rhea dyan, no?
Oh, yes.
And okay, of course, laging understanding na professor ko from WEMSU,
mm-hmm,
si Professor Jomai Guapo Alvarez.
Okay.
Good afternoon,
sir,
to you, sir. And of course, sa mga professors, no, and teachers of Western Mindanao State University.
Yes.
Good
congratulations
afternoon
to the graduates of 2018.
Of course, no?
Mm-hmm.
And of course, kay Bebe.
Okay,
no?
Nami-miss natin siya.
Bebe Joey,
nasa Cadende Oro na eh.
Andun na, andun
yun na.
Na
eh. Okay, babalik so, lang yun.
Babalik pa rin yun. Huh? Tulungan tayo.
Yes.
And of course, ating kaibigan na walang sawang suporta na binibigay sa atin,
yes,
partner, si Sir Ed Delegario.
Okay.
And of course, to all the Pantawid Pamilya Pilipino Program partners in Mabuhay, Zamboanga, Cebu, guy. And we will be soon seeing you again for our next training.
After ng Holo, diretso na sa Mabuhay ulit. Okay, talagang
so,
patindi ng
paghandaan mo na.
Wait ka kasi ang Cotabato naghihintay din.
Nandun na sila.
Yes, nandun din nagpe-pesto. So
then, you know, also to my friends, si makasama ko sa office.
Oh, no? Yes.
To all of you, good afternoon. And just keep on listening, no?
And yes, and thank you for supporting the program.
Yes,
dan talaga
so
sa area mo nagsimula.
Correct.
Lahat.
Okay. Kaya lagi pasalamat natin, no, sa kanila at even to this radio station.
Oh yes.
To give us this opportunity, no, para at least
to be the voice.
To be the voice.
Yes.
And
the synergy.
Correct.
Yes. Partner, during our fourth episode last week, we were able to discuss about the top 10 most deadliest disease. Okay?
Correct.
And then siguro naman i-highlight natin yan ulit kasi nandito po ang rightful authority na mag-share din po sa in terms of Zamboanga City. Ano-ano po ba ang nangyayari din? And then we hope to also take a look at yung isang area doon na sinasabi natin madalas hindi po natin pinapansin. Like for example, ano po ba ang dahilan kung bakit may mga barangay health centers, partner?
Yes, partner.
Lalong-lalo na sa mga areas na wala pang hospital.
Correct.
Gaano to pa importante. Okay? And then so we would like to basically I'm very much excited to have here with us one of the prominent personalities coming from the public health unit of Zamboanga City Medical Center.
Wow!
Oh, yung sinasabi natin, alam mo ba partner, to be honest with you?
Yes, partner.
Simulat sa poll, hindi niya po yun alam na isa siya sa mga lodi or iniidolo kong pagdating sa kagalingan,
wow,
at kagwapuhan.
Ganon?
Totoo yun.
Wow.
And his name in Arabic means most superior.
Most superior.
Ni-research ko yan. Talaga, wow, yun ang ibig sabihin
niya. Talagang pinagandaan yung pag-research.
Oo, oh, bata pa ako in elementary, patok ng pangalan niya. Kasi nababasa ko yung isang newspaper sa isang, yes, ano, sa dati niyang ano, kung saan, alma mater niya. Isa siya sa mga
so,
sikat
ibig sabihin,
na writer.
High profile to.
Oh, yes. Hindi lamang po siya astig sa pagiging matalino.
Grabe,
kundi
ah,
magaling talaga siya sa maraming bagay.
Sige, we'll okay, listen on that.
He is a very good writer, speaker, leader, and public servant, lalo na sa kanyang piniling larangan, mm-hmm, or profesyon sa buhay, ang pagiging ganap na doktor. At kasama pa niya ang magaling niyang nurse na maganda na matalino pa.
Oh.
Okay, so partner, baka gusto mong i-introduce na sila dito sa episode natin.
Oh, sure, partner. So it is my honor to introduce our friend's partner, no? Of course, ladies and gentlemen, to formally introduce to you, we would like to welcome you, our friends, Dr. Afdal Kunting and Ma'am Nikita Bunag.
Bunag.
Good afternoon to all of you.
Okay. Hello, Doctor.
Hello.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Okay.
Good afternoon. Good
afternoon, Sir. We would like to say thank you for heeding the invitation. Alam namin busy po talaga kayo.
It's our pleasure.
Yeah. Pakinggan mong boses
niya. Yeah,
parang radio commentator din.
Yeah,
actually, nakikita na natin siya sa TV sa Deadline Teleradio.
Okay.
Isa siya sa talagang pinag-aabangan ko pag guest yan siya kasi ang dami niyang alam.
Mm-hmm.
So aalamin na natin ano ba ang ginagawa ng isang chief officer o yung yan ano po sa public health unit. I'm referring to Dr. Kunting. Doc, thank you for heeding our invitation once again, but we would just like to find out ang unit niyo po ba sa medical center. Ano po ang main function nila?
So good afternoon. Again, thank you very much for inviting us over. So basically, the public health unit, ano siya eh, yun yung parang health advocacy component ng hospitals. Kasi when you talk about hospitals, basically, ang inisip natin, curative.
Yes.
Kung may sakit, pumunta ka doon. But you see, most of the sickness naman natin sa Pilipinas is preventable.
Mm-hmm.
So although role yan ng ating tinatawag na public health component, itong mga city health office, pero ang ating Department of Health had thought na it is important as well for hospitals to have a unit that is responsible for promotion of health and then of preventing disease. So,
okay.
Yun po yung role namin sa, not just in the hospital, lumalabas din kami sa communities.
Okay, so knowing na yun talaga ang mandate ngayon, can you also elaborate pa po kung anong mga programs and services na naibibigay ng unit ninyo, Doc?
So basically, aside from health teachings, no, so basically si Ma'am Nikki ang in charge sa ating inpatient health teachings. So pumupunta siya sa mga wards, kinakausap niya mga watchers. Ang Department of Health, meron siyang lineup of activities na monthly. So yun ang parang template namin. We go with that. We basically, like for example, there are months na we talk about mga bulate, no, yung mga brushing of teeth, mga ganun yung, so yun din ang ginagawa namin. But there are times when there's like really big problems, like for example there are times na pag masyadong umulan, and then there's a risk for leptospirosis, so we include these things based on the need of the community.
Okay, so Dr. Afdal, we also would like to know personal experience nyo sa the field in the community as a expert professional and even the chief of as chief of a public health officer, ano po yung mga experience natin sa field po?
Basically, in terms of public health kasi, when I started after medical school, I went to work as a municipal health officer sa Seri Osmeña, Zamboanga del Norte.
Okay.
So I spent 7 years there. It was it's a very nice place. It's high up in the mountains, very cool, parang Baguio siya.
Okay.
So I had a good time there, and then after about 7 years, I came back and worked sa city health office natin as the district health officer of Sangali Health District.
I see.
So,
and what motivates you, Doc, to serve our community people, no? In the community? And how do you respond such challenges na meron tayo sa community?
Mm-hmm.
Siguro, you feel... Like for us, no, I didn't come from a rich family. I came from very ordinary beginnings. And being a doctor kasi is such a blessing for me. You'll be able to leave na yung your life behind and get a much better life.
Okay.
So hindi natin nakakalimutan yung mga saan tayo galing, 'di ba? Sabi nila, for you to be able to chart your future, you must remember the past. The past will shape the individual.
Living on sa pinanggalingan.
Yeah. Kailangan kasi doon tayo galing. So we have to help other people who are in the same circumstances. The Philippines kasi, we are a third world country.
Tama.
There's so much opportunity to make a difference in the lives of people and improve the way that they live. There is an opportunity to go abroad for many of us, mga health professionals.
Yes. Tama po.
Mga doctors, mga nurses. But you know, it's very important to serve your people. Iba pa rin yung feeling. Yes. Hindi mo man may earn as much as
they do.
But again, we are trying to advocate the concept of social wealth. Kasi ang financial wealth kasi, makukuha mo pag nagtrabaho ka sa labas. Nakukuha man din dito sa atin, but not as much. But the concept of social wealth is the when we treat our patients, we help them get better. So yung love, yung appreciation ng mga friends, our relatives, our patients, the community is something that cannot be counted in terms of money. So yun ang tinatawag kong social wealth. At yun ang ating pino-promote sa ating mga students. I also teach at the medical school sa Ateneo. Yun din ang konsepto ng Ateneo de Zamboanga School of Medicine. The concept of social wealth and going out and serving the community and being rewarded by the love of your patients.
Tama po. Actually, timing talaga yung usaping ito, partner, kasi mas nag-coin niya ng maganda yung term na social wealth. And then alam natin hindi natin pwedeng ganap yun ma-i-implement pag walang health education, doc.
Correct.
No? So gusto ko din linawin, being the chief officer ng public health unit, ano po yung connection ng public health unit sa health education? Kung sa kasakali po.
Well, basically, public health unit is health education.
Okay.
Basically, yun. They are synonymous. But our scope, meron kasi yung parang meron siyang parang dichotomy or some new terminologies that are coming up. When you talk about public health, we're only talking about what the Department of Health, what the City Health Office, what the hospital does in terms of addressing the problems.
Yes.
But kami, what we're trying to do is, we're not yet there, but what we're trying to advocate is population health.
Okay,
and that's population
good.
Health is a concept in which hindi lang tayo magpo-focus on the person and disease, mga ganyan. We will also focus on what we call the social determinants of health. For example, illness is not just because you are sick, no, or may bacteria, but because wala kang perang pampunta sa hospital.
Exactly.
Wala kang makain na nutritious food, diba? And then, of course, the area that we live in, the sanitation. So, all of these things, yung education natin, the road networks, the support systems, and communities. In fact, the World Health Organization says that yung mga access to health, no, hospital ba or health center ba, yung impact nila sa total health ng individual is not as much as the impact of your relationship with family and community. So na-identify na, and that's why ito na yung bagong trend ngayon, is going towards population health and not just public health.
Wow.
Yes.
Talagang saktong-sakto, partner, kung titingnan mo yung Hello Help.
Correct.
Yung platform na yan, that's really health education, then encompassing life coaching. At malaki ang sakop ng life coach . Kasi una-una, going back to the roots sa family.
Yes.
Sabi nga ni doctor kanina, di ba, na talagang everything, makita mo ang lahat ng social determinants sa pagdating lang sa area na yan. Ngayon, kausapin din natin, partner. Huwag mong kalimutan, may maganda tayong kasama.
Kaya,
Dok, babalikan din namin kayo.
So,
okay?
Ma'am Nikita. So, as a registered nurse, no, mga ilang taon na po kaya sa servisyo?
Oh, well, sa Zamboanga City Medical Center, I've been serving there for almost 13 years. I've been with Blood Bank for 10 years and 2 years sa Public Health Unit.
Wow, talagang experienced na
So,
Ma'am Nikita, so what are the challenges that you have experienced along the way? And how this challenges
when we speak of hospital setting, no, kasi yung role ko talaga dyan sa public health unit, I give health teaching, so I hop from one ward to another, so alam yun naman yung patients namin dyan sa hospital. Makikita mo talaga na they came from walang-wala, no? So I really have a soft heart kasi makikita mo talaga na when they go there, yung ano ba, yung ma, kung magkwento kayo sa kanila, they cannot really right away go to the hospital and okay. seek for ano, no? Kasi ang dami nilang ano, kailangan pa para makarating sila sa hospital. So, sabi ko, hanggang ngayon ba, ano pa rin, what you call that, may shortage pa talaga tayo ng mga health workers in rural as well as in remote
Tama
areas.
Po.
No? So, kasi pagdating nila sa hospital, yung pasyente nila, grabe na. So, when you talk to the watcher, oh, bakit ngayon yun lang? Kasi walang hospital, wala mang health center sa area namin. Tapos, hanap pa kami ng pera para makarating.
Yes.
So, nakakaawa. Okay. So, that's why as a nurse, no, pag when I do my health teaching, I really see to it that talagang ma-impart ko sa kanila yung talagang importanting points
yes.
para naman sila mismo, lalo na yung mga watchers, sila mismo magkakaroon, they will be equipped,
yes.
no? Magkakaroon sila knowledge, skills, kung anong nangyari dun sa ano pasyente nila. So, by the time nababalik sila sa ano nila, community nila, sila mismo magiging health advocate din.
Wow. So, partner, talaga sinasabi ko na tumitindi ang balahibo ko
Correct.
Nito. Kasi, honestly speaking, bago natin silang kinausap, parang everything is aligning to its stars.
Correct.
Diba? Kasi, yung concept ng Hello Health, by the way, Doc, it all started with just ideas.
Concept.
And then we did not realize na concept lang yun. Tapos
yes.
pinisenta niya to sa DSWD, Mabuhay.
Yes.
And it was awarded as one of the best convergence initiative program na hindi pa nga po na-implement, pero inawardan na. Kaya nga po, kailangan namin to. I would like to go back to you. And then, since the Hello Health serves as convergence initiative, hindi po kami nakikocompete because actually ngayon ko lang nalaman ang ganda ng term na social wealth. Samantala, we are promoting social entrepreneurship. It's also part of social wealth. And I think, sabi nyo nga, ang goal lang ngayon ng DOH is not just to cure the disease, but to help people who doesn't even have access to public services, who cannot even, sabi nyo, walang makain, walang ano. How do we get to empower them? And I was led to ask you the question, how can we mainstream this together? Now that kayo po ang nasa authority, we don't want to compete actually. Our purpose why we put the radio program is to synergize all together.
Yes.
The government, the non-government, the civic club organizations so that we can have an impact. Kasi ang nangyayari talagang madalas, tulad ng Barangay Health Center, pwede nyo po bang konti ng shed light about it? Kasi I, for one, 38 years na po ako, pero never pa po ako nakarating sa Barangay Health Center for services. Ewan ko kung bakit. Ang tanging alam ko sa Barangay Health Center, purpose nila, mag-inject lang for bakuna and all. But is this what Barangay Health Centers being part of the public health unit, not just in the hospitals, is this exactly their main function lang? Or ano po talagang pinaka-mandate na?
Siguro a little background on our health system lang no, before we talk about the Barangay Health Station. So basically, our health system is a, because of the Devolution Act no, of 1990 ata yun by the Senator Pimentel. So nagkaroon ng devolution. So
okay.
The Department of Health does not have direct access, direct control and supervision over the other health systems.
Mm-hmm.
So sa local government unit, for example, sa city, ang boss nila, ang leader nila is the mayor.
Okay.
Okay. So tapos, we have sort of like a parallel is the center, regional center for DOH. And then we have the national government.
Mm-hmm.
So hindi siya ano eh, hindi siya parang one command structure. So there's many command structures. So yung Barangay Health Center falls under the city health office.
Okay.
Okay. They are the primary first line component natin ng health, no? They are responsible for looking at individuals, yung first contact, sila dapat, sila yung mga
okay.
sentinels natin sa communities na tumitingin na may problema, may
sila
mga
issues. Sila yung mga direct, ano?
Sila yung mga direct.
Provider.
Ang problem kasi natin, syempre, we are a poor country.
Mm.
So, you might have barangay health stations, but we do not have a doctor for every community, no?
Yes,
we do not have a barangay health station na lahat may doctor. Although, hindi naman siya technically kailangan. So, yun kasi yung isa sa mga concepts na kailangan natin ma-determine kasi meron niya tinatawag na doctor to patient ratio.
Okay.
So hindi, although we're a big city, no, so dapat mas marami tayong public health na doctors in the field, pero limited lang din yung capabilities natin.
Tama.
Ang sabi nila, eh bakit hindi kayo mag-hire ng maraming doktor? Mm-hmm. Diba? It's what people usually say. But there's also a dynamics in hiring because number one, in the budget of our local governments, meron niyang mga limitations kung ilan lang ang ma-hire mo kasi sweldo yan, benefits yan, mga ganyang bagay. Exactly. So nangyayari kasi, what's happening is each doctor is forced to see several barangays. Mm. Several barangays. For example, sa Mabuhay, no? Sa Mabuhay, isang doktor lang sila.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Dito sa Zamboanga City, we have about 24 or 26 doctors.
For all the 98 barangays?
For all the 98 barangays. Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. So, but of course, we also have our hospitals here. We have Zamboanga City Medical Center. We have the private hospitals.
Tama.
In the periphery, we have Vitali, Kiniput, Labuan. We have Ayala as well.
Yes.
So, meron naman tayong mga areas na kung saan meron tayong systems. Ang ano lang kasi, ang problem lang kasi is we also have our people do not have access. Not really have access. The stations are there. But some of our stations, syempre, pag wala yung doctor doon, hindi sila pupunta. Or, minsan, ang midwife kasi, in charge, usually may midwife and in charge sa isang barangay. Apo. And then there is one nurse, one or two nurses in charge of the district. So, sila yung in charge doon. So, sometimes, it's because non-functional. But I think most of the, ano naman sa atin, ay functional. I think the problem with non-functional health centers is in areas like Mabuhay, na kahit ang midwife, eh, nagsiserve siya ng ilang barangays.
No, tama po yun.
Dito sa atin, I think every barangay has a midwife.
At least buti na po.
But we have limited number of nurses and limited number of doctors. So again, iba-iba po yung situations ng mga health systems natin. If you are talking about small districts, small municipalities and bigger cities, iba-iba siya.
Mm-hmm.
So ang problem dito is the lack of health workers, mm-hmm, as well as also the culture of our people, kultura. Correct. And the behavior, yung tinatawag naming health seeking behaviors.
Mm-hmm.
So minsan kahit masama ng pakiramdam, hindi pa rin magko-consult hanggang medyo gabi na, and that's when
malapit
nang
mamatay sa kapo.
Saka siya,
sa kapo pupunta doon.
But again, even if that is the case, we also cannot really just say, bakit ngayon lang, no?
Yes.
Because marami ding factors, like sinabi ni Ma'am Nikki, wala naman silang pera,
mm-hmm,
wala naman silang sasakyan, wala naman silang means na, for example, sila lang dalawa, paano yung mga ibang anak nila na may iwan? So, all of these things we have to take into consideration. Ika nga sabi nila, mahirap mag-judge sa tao at that point in time because hindi natin alam yung nangyari sa kanila sa labas. Tayo, tinatanggap natin siya sa hospital at that point in time, yun lang yung nakikita natin.
Yes.
Hindi natin nakita yung mga bagay. Yung pala, kailangan ibenta yung baboy,
mm-hmm,
or yung baka para makapunta doon, or isanla yung bahay. Just to have their,
Yes po, no, Doc. No?
Sige.
Kasi ito po yung pinaka talagang problema natin sa community. Especially doon sa Mabuhay.
No? Tama
ka. Nakikita natin doon, experience natin. So, ito yung pinaka talagang problema na sinabi nyo kanina. Karoon tayo ng kakulangan. Kasi sa amin doon, talagang nahihirapan yung mga tao doon. Lalo na pag-access sa health facility. Kasi nga, yun nga, sabi ni Ma'am na walang pera. Kulang yung budget para pangpamasahin, no? So, siguro ito yung mga challenges na nakikita
natin.
Dapat
nating tingnan.
Yes, okay. Kaya nga dito tayo ngayon para at least
linawin natin. Okay, siguro lang balikan natin knowing na ito yung sitwasyon. Doc, sa tingin nyo, paano po ba, based on your experience po, no? I know you are also, somehow, I don't like the word struggling, but somehow you are envisioning na one day, maganap natin maano yung public education or health education even in the barangays.
Yes.
So partner, baka may gusto kang tanungin pa sa kanya.
I just would like to know, no, as kay Doc at saka kay Ma'am, what is your greatest fulfillment, no?
Uh-huh.
And of course, paano nyo tinignan as very significant tong gawain natin bilang isang mga worker sa government, no?
Yes. Parang Miss Universe ang question.
Parang Miss Universe ang question.
Sige. Grabe. Anong greatest fulfillment? Ito gusto kong malaman sa kanya.
Talagang grabe, ah.
Kasi knowing Dr. Afdal, hindi niya talaga alam na may stalker siya sa mga ano.
Ganon.
Meron talaga. Ganon. In fairness to him, it was his writings that actually motivated me to write.
Yes.
Siya yung dating binabasa ko after the great Liza Masuhod. Mm-hmm. Siya na yung younger. Mm-hmm. Binabasa ko yung mga write-ups nila as editor-in-chief.
Stalker ako.
Nagbabasa ako eh. Kaya nung nalaman ko na somebody, a doctor din na nag-refer sa kanya, ang saya-saya ko. Sabi, finally, I will come to see him for the first time na hindi niya alam. Doc, sige po.
Yes, Doc.
Kami kasi, the fulfillment comes from the simplest of things.
Okay.
So, kung mag-thank you sa amin, okay na yun para sa amin. It's not about money or prestige or fame. It's the simple things in life. Kaya nga importante yung konsepto ng social wealth.
Tama
kasi po. Yung mga bagay na yun, it makes you feel so good, no? That when you teach people, and at the end they say, Doc, alam mo, may natutunan ako. Or Doc, thank you mafulfill, magagawa namin to sa community namin.
So,
sa amin, yung for me, I don't know, si Ma'am Nikki, so yung simple thank you, ano na yon? That's big, but that's very big for me already. And for me, that's the greatest fulfillment.
Wow. Sige. May millions na thank you tayo after dito. Okay.
Yes, so what about Mom? Yes.
No, for me as a nurse, no. I really get in contact with patients sa hospital na talagang walang-wala. And these are the people whom talagang binibigyan ko ng oras talaga,
yes,
to really teach them.
Okay, no? That's good.
Kasi sila talaga nangangailangan eh. And although nahihirapan ako kasi talagang tinatanong ko sila kung anong dialect na talagang maintindihan nila.
Mm-hmm.
No? So, imagine, pati Tagalog, hindi nila maiintindihan. So,
totoo yun, ma'am. Totoo,
yeah,
yun.
So, what I do, I make my health teaching very, very, creative.
Wow. Yes.
Na parang laro, na fine, not laro in the sense na laro lang, joke lang, no? Just like what happened sa Ward 8, yun yung Pedyo Ward namin ha, sa hospital. I went to this isolation room saan merong 6 na pasyente na may measles, tigdas, okay, no? Outbreak yan, di ba? Nagka-outbreak,
yes,
yan.
Yes.
So, karamihan doon, yung mga pasyente, they come from, poor barangays, no? Tapos, 3 pa nandoon, tapos, I situate one-on-one ako mag-health teaching para talagang, mm-hmm, maintindihan nila ba? Tapos sabi ko, anong maintindihan nyo, Tagalog, hindi daw. So, paano to? So, I really make it a point na mag-health teaching ako with kasabay na yung action. I'm so happy, I'm so fulfilled na sila na magturo sa akin na kasi naintindihan nila yung actions ko. So, I'm so fulfilled kasi meron na nagkaroon ng interaction.
Wow.
No, so
that's good.
Yeah, yun yung natutuwa talaga ako doon. Ibig sabihin kasi naintindihan nila.
Yes.
Yeah. So hindi sayang yung health teaching.
True gesture lang pala.
True gesture. Actually, talaga yung isang Tagalog na word, talagang may mga action.
Mix na siya.
So
action star ka.
Kasi di ba, actually, my goal na ako, talagang maintindihan nila. So by the time na pupunta, babalik sila dun sa bahay nila, sa community nila, makakatulong din sila sa iba.
Yes. Siguro kung walang passion si Ma'am, mahirapan talaga kasi yun nga, no, kahit body language lang naintindihan na nila.
At saka kung yun, go ahead, Ma'am.
Yeah, that's why I really learned to love this job.
Wow.
Na, yeah. Kaya nang magbibigay ng health station.
Sige.
Okay.
More to come pa kay Ma'am in the next day. Sige po. Ah, partner, mayroon pa. Kasi ako, marami na akong inilagay na tanong. I-reserve natin yan mamaya.
Sige, mamaya yan, partner.
Okay. Siguro, Now that we have initially heard from our chief officer of the public health unit, our line is now open for any questions, reactions, or commentaries. Please feel free to reach us through the numbers 0916-296625. I repeat, 0916-296625, and that is our DXAS 1116, your community radio hotline. Or you may also reach us to 0935-0888885. I repeat, 0888885 for Hello Help hotline number as well. Kaya abangan po ninyo ang programa namin dahil marami po kayong mapupulot ang aral kung paano masolusyunan ang pabalik-balik na sakit, ang kahirapan sa buhay at kung paano magkaroon ng magandang kalusugan at magandang buhay. In the advocacy of enriching one's passion, transforming lives, we shall make it happen.
At maaari din po ninyo kaming maabot sa FB page ng 1116DXAS FEBC Radio and check us out on YouTube's for Hello Health Program Files, now on our fifth edition. And just type Hello Health Program and please feel to post your reactions or comments regarding our weekly episode. Galak po namin kayong makakomment anytime. We shall not be having our short break. Stay tuned to Hello Health for more updates and do not change radio program. We will be right back.
Okay.
Sitting in her mother's arms with sadness in her eyes. The doctor said, I'm sorry, ma'am, there's just no hope inside. The family gathered around her and on their knees began to pray. As the tears fell like rain, you could hear her mother say, Lord, I need a today, please just let one pass my way. I believe in you. Help me overcome this fear inside. This pain's too much for me to hide. Lord, see me through. I need a miracle from you. Drunken man stumbled in the church house cause he had no place to go. The loss of his family left him grieving in his soul. The preacher stood and spoke of how Jesus loves you anyway. With the choice he had to run or stay, the man bowed his head and girl is now a wife with kids of her own, and the man who bowed his head has led many to the throne. Let one pass my way. I believe in you.
This is your community radio, 1116 DXAS, communicating Christ in our world.
Welcome back, dear friends, to our Hello Help program. And yes, Lord, you see me through in times of sickness and loneliness. I need a miracle from you. Help us overcome this pain inside. We are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. And yes, indeed, there can be miracles when you believe.
And of course, you're still with my partner Alain and our dear guest, Dr. Afdal Kunting and Mrs. Bunag.
Okay.
And of course, we shall continue with our segment and going back to our discussion a while ago. Doc, what are the important things that the public, shall we say, the public should know regarding the need to live a healthy lifestyle?
Yeah, we have heard of the concept, no? Health is wealth.
Yes.
Yes.
So if you are healthy, it allows you to live, to be able to fulfill what you want in life.
Yes.
So if you're always sick, you're always in the hospital, it's very expensive to be sick right now. In fact, one of our topics that we like to teach is what we call the economics of heart disease.
Okay.
A lot of people think na, eh, kung ma-admit ako, ganito lang ang gasto. So what we did was we went through estimations of the cost of hospitalization.
Okay.
And then we told them na, for example, a stroke patient, how much do you spend, no, when you admit in a public hospital, a private hospital? And then how much if you use this for medications?
Exactly.
Sometimes one admission lang is about 6 months worth of medications already.
Mm-hmm.
So sabi namin sa kanila, look, you know, if you get sick, you spend a lot.
Yes.
If you just buy medications, it's already 6 months. Sometimes if you buy medicines from CCMC, because we sell very low price medicines, no, kasi we buy in bulk kasi.
Mm-hmm.
So you can even have that good for 1 year already, your medications, your one admission only for a stroke or a heart attack.
Yes.
So it's very important to maintain your health, because this allows you to be socially, economically productive, and that's what our nation needs right now.
Tama po, yes. Tama po. Knowing yung a while ago when we were when we were playing that song, we were discussing about yung is it okay for people to know? Because our main point why we came up with this radio program is to really educate people.
Correct.
So going back to one of them, to the area where you are serving, can we possibly know every day? Can you give or share to us roughly an estimate of ilang tao po ba talaga ang nakakapasok dun sa Zamboanga City Medical Center?
I can only speak for Department of Internal Medicine kasi okay. I'm also a consultant there. So I sit down for what we call endorsement rounds every Tuesday mornings. So usually for adult patients nito, no, internal medicine. So roughly mga around 20 to 23 patients that mm-hmm. come in. Yesterday, they had 26 admissions. The day before that, they had only 10. So, average. Pero around the average is about, siguro around 20, 15, 20, 22, mga ganyan. So, that's for internal medicine.
Okay.
So, if you go to our emergency room, you will see na punong-puno talaga yan.
Yes.
Punong-puno. And then what we have another sort of a problem in the sense, because right now, Zamboanga City Medical Center, because of the need to serve more people, we need to build bigger buildings.
Yes, tama po.
So in the course of that, we are now building yung Tower A, the groundwork is being set for that. Nagpa-pilings na sila and everything in preparation for the foundation. But we had to clear out some buildings. So we lost our senior citizen ward. That's 10 beds. Mm. We lost our ward 6.
Mm-hmm.
Ward 6 and 7. So that's maybe around 30 beds. And then we lost the onco ward of pediatrics. So right now, siksikan talaga.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you go to the ER, sometimes hindi na namin maakyat sila to the wards. They have to stay at the ER. Because we have no place already.
Sa dami-daming mga taong pumapasok sa hospital araw-araw,
Doc, can we possibly know, ano lang muna, I know na nakalimutan nyo pong ano, yung data na to. Yung common lang po talagang diseases na laging ano, nakikita o laging na-encounter ninyo.
Pabalik-balik siya.
Pabalik-balik, yes. So usually, before when we were students, karamihan ng admissions would be pneumonia, acute gastroenteritis, yung tai-tai, and then tuberculosis. Right, pero ngayon nakikita namin kasi sabi nila ang Philippines kasi eh nandito na tayo sa in between na tayo sa developing and developed.
Yes.
Pag developing countries, karamihan ng sakit niyan yung mga infectious diseases, no?
Okay.
Yes. Pag mga developed countries, yun yung mga cardiovascular lifestyle diseases, diabetes, mm-hmm. hypertension. Tayo unfortunately sa atin in between.
So, okay.
We have infectious diseases. We still have admissions for pneumonia, tuberculosis, mm-hmm. mga malaria. We have mga hepatitis, mga ganyan. But, marami na talaga tayong mga cases na stroke,
okay.
mga heart attacks, diabetes, mm-hmm. mga diabetic foods, mga ganun. So, we are saddled with the twin burden of disease. When before, ang pinoproblema lang namin is yung infectious diseases. Okay. Pero ngayon, we already have to grapple with lifestyle diseases. So, it's very important yung advocacy na healthy living, decrease your caloric intake. Kasi masyadong marami na tayong mga ang pagkain natin is western already.
Yes.
And then our activity level is already very western. Sedentary yes. na rin ang mga tao. So with a high energy consumption, with a less energy expenditures, medyo tumataba na rin ang mga tao. So yun, marami na rin tayong cases.
And Doc, siguro alam natin no, nowadays especially na mainit yung panahon natin. Kasi talagang climate change na nga eh.
No? Exactly.
So, pwede ba natin malaman, Doc, kung ano ba talagang pinaka-mabigat, no? Na talagang mabigat yung pinaka-pangunahing sakit lang or diseases na na-encounter talaga natin. Yung kahit isa lang, no? Kasi alam natin kung ano talagang pinaka-mabigat sa panahon ngayon.
I think one of the most dangerous diseases na lumabas because of our climate change is dengue.
Okay.
Dengue. I may be mistaken, no, but ang sabi kasi nila, the dengue mosquitoes, Aedes aegypti, ano siya eh, sa mainit siya.
Mm-hmm.
So as our communities become warmer and warmer, we will have more and more dengue. Sabi nga nung isang article na nabasa ko, in Africa, yung Nairobi in Kenya,
yes,
high altitude siya. Yun ang nabasa ko. Sabi nila, as global warming becomes more prevalent, noon wala silang mosquitoes kasi malamig.
Tama po.
Ngayon, marami na silang mosquitoes. So I think it's the same, it's happening. I remember when I was a medical student, dengue hindi namin masyadong kilala.
Yes.
And pag mag-appear siya, it's like an epidemic, no? Pero ngayon, ang nangyari sa atin, parang hyper-endemic, meaning it occurs all throughout the year na and in yes. high numbers.
At umakyat pa, nagle-level up. There's such a thing yes. as dengue chikungunya. Tama po ba?
Another virus naman yun. Yes. Another causative agent naman yun siya. So, yun, nung time na yun, wala yun eh. Pero ngayon, nandito na siya because ng carrier niya tsaka ang carrier ng dengue, magkapareho lang.
Pero grabe no, patindi yes. ng patindi sila.
Patindi ng patindi.
Dumadami na eh.
That's why our community has to realize, whenever you cut trees, and whenever you, kasi yung mga puno kasi, we know na sila yung nagsesegregate ng carbon sa atmosphere natin. When you cut down trees, you lose your capability to sequester carbon from the environment.
Exactly.
So ngayon, ang problema natin, mataas ang carbon dioxide sa ano natin. That's why mainit tayo. Okay. So when you continue to cut down trees, you do not stop deforestation. Ito yung mangyayari. Aside from that, flash flooding, tinan niyo nangyari sa Chocon.
Exactly.
'Di ba?
Tama po.
I have the patient from Chocon. Nung nag-flash flood, old guy, 86 years old. He had to stand the whole night on a chair. Tapos hanggang ulo niya yung, hanggang neck niya yung tubig.
Wala ka.
Oh, syempre. So pagdating niya dito, admit ka agad siya kasi yes. 86 na kaya si tatay.
Yes.
And they were ano, their house was devastated. Mm-hmm. This is because we don't care for our environment.
Mm-hmm.
Madali maraming tao will say, "Oh, we'll help our environment, we'll plant trees," but they don't do anything.
Correct.
It's only when there's ano, it's only when there is may sakuna, there's flooding, that yes. they're also noisy in social media.
Exactly.
Pag wala na rin nagtatanim ng puno, wala na rin nag-reforestation, our people in the community still continue to cut down trees and make them into charcoal, sell them as firewood.
Yes.
Hindi nila nare-realize. Ultimately, this will come back to haunt them.
Exactly.
At babalik yan, no? Yeah. You know, magigigante.
Yun ang partner nung correct. Una pang episode natin, sinabi ko sa iyo na yes. main problem talaga ng majority ng Filipinos, short-sighted tayo.
Correct.
Hindi, wala tayong foresight. Yung sinasabi ni Doc na saka nga lang nandun na, maingay, pero kung wala pa yung time na hindi pa po tinamaan, wala lang.
Hindi pa gagalaw.
Adamant lang sila. Walang pakialam.
Correct.
For example, yung last time na nagkaroon tayo ng floodings sa norte, sa sur, so, to test my theory, nag-post ako. Sabi ko, if you want, I can provide free seedlings for you.
Mm-hmm.
Walang takers. Maraming nagko-complain. Oh,
so, walang gusto nun.
Walang gusto. Oh, for people like us, kami ang mag-plan, kami maghanap ng paraan. So, we've been doing that sa Zamboanga City Medical Center. Now, we're planting Nara because mm-hmm. we need to plant. You don't just need to plant trees, you also need to plant the right type of trees.
Exactly.
No? So, ang trend natin ngayon is to bring back our indigenous native trees because ito yung suited para sa ating climate.
Tama
so,
po.
Ngayon nagtatanim tayo ng mga Nara, mga Molave, mga ganyan. So, nagtatanim din kami doon. And then I'm also with the Philippine College of Physicians, so we're also doing tree plantings with PCP and Rotary as well.
Okay,
so
ito yung
mga advocacies natin. Yes. Pero we want to see more of this from other people. Kasi pag magkaroon ng flooding, pagkaroon ng problema, hindi lang naman kami ang affected, pati
tama
sila.
Po, exactly.
The problem is our communities, our people, parang wala nangyari. Tapos na, wala nang problema. Wala na yung Yolanda, wala na yung mga ano. De, wala na, okay na lang sila. Until the next one comes along and they all shout, "What's the government doing?" I think we should stop asking what the government is doing for us.
Exactly.
We should start asking ourselves, is this the world I want my child to grow up with?
Tama yes. po kayo. Tama
kasi
po.
Kung if you care for your child, ayaw mo na mag-deteriorate ito.
Exactly.
Okay. Kung wala kang pakialam sa anak mo, you don't do anything. But if you care for your child, we have to. Kasi in the end, our children will ask us, "Dad, what did you do for me?"
Exactly.
And this is also the problem of our government talaga. No? Mm-hmm. Na minsan kasi alam natin na they don't even give focus no on environmental aspect natin. No? Na talagang nasisira na patuloy. No? So kaya it's our duties and responsibilities na talagang tulungan natin. Kaya we have to ask them back kung is this what you want? No? Kaya tama yung doc na sinabi natin.
Oo, kaya, pwede na yung palaging isisi sa gobyerno.
Correct.
Oo, palagi, it sort of removes your responsibility from you. As a citizen of this nation, it is our responsibility to help improve the status of our communities
correct.
As good citizens.
Tama po.
Eh kung palagi na tayo gobyerno, the government can only do as much. Sipin mo pag lahat tayo nagtanim ng puno, lahat tayo nag-care, we are 100 million.
Exactly.
And we can reforestate our nation.
Correct.
But we're not doing it because gobyerno, trabaho ng gobyerno yan eh. But that's not supposed to be the way. If you
yes.
are, if you care for the future of your children, you need to say, "I don't care what government does, I will do my part."
Yes.
Dapat correct. yun ang mindset natin.
Correct. The same way when we talk about, relate back our topic to health education, importante talaga nga yung sinasabi mong pananagutan sa sarili mo.
Correct.
Kasi walang disiplina ang Pilipino. Generally,
yun ang
problema, we can tell that.
The attitude.
Oo, yung attitude.
It's a problem.
So, now that we are here, I know that yung battle cry ni na Doc on the field is, sana mas lalo natin ma-intensify itong program na to. Kaya I'm really grateful, Doc, na when you asked me that question on the first day when I called you, isang beses lang pa po ba ito? Will this be a one-shot deal? Mm-hmm. And my answer, no. It's going to be a series of ano, because nakita natin ang problema ngayon eh. We have heard from them na ito yung sa kalusugan lang nga alone, hindi mo maitanggi na yung climate change, yung environment plays a role.
Correct.
Kung maganda yung ano, yung situation, okay yung ano, kalusugan natin, but hindi naintindihan ng tao yan eh. Hindi naintindihan ng tao hangga't hindi sila nagkasakit.
We use ano eh, to drive the point, no? To drive the point. In my lectures, in our lectures, we always tell them, what's the biggest killer in the world?
Yes.
People say, oh, cardiovascular, diabetes. One of the biggest killer in the world happened, I think, in 2004.
Yes.
During the Indian Ocean tsunami. Okay. 100,000 people, more than 100,000 people dead in a span of hours.
My God.
Yung sa, di ba, yung nangyari sa Banda Aceh, sa Thailand.
Exactly po.
See? In one click. Ilang oras lang yon, daming namatay. Yolanda, how many namatay?
Yes.
Thousands.
So,
a disease can kill, several hundred na day. But yon, in an hour, in 4 hours, ganun ang... So, we have to realize, and even for the medical community to realize, na it's not always about yung profession ninyo, but it's always being able to look at the big picture. Mm-hmm. And right now, our biggest killer is not the disease. Mm-hmm. It is the environment.
Tama po.
And our environment is paying us back for all the neglect and all the abuses that we are doing right now. Kaya sabi namin, dapat yung mga illegal loggers, yung mga mining, should be held accountable for what is happening right now. Tama to po. Us. Kasi kung hindi nila kinat yung mga puno na yan, we will not have this problem.
Mm-hmm. Tama po.
Kasi diyan kasi nagsimula yung lahat eh. Uh-huh. No? Pagka yung ginagawa ng mga tao na sa pagkat ng trees kaya nagkaroon ng mga sakit. Mm-hmm. Okay, kasi siyempre lumalabas din diyan yung mga viruses. Mm-hmm. Dahil wala nang kumokontrol, wala nang napoprotect sa mga environment like mga living things na kung saan ito nakakatulong sa atin, no? Kaya yun. And sa pag-advocacy natin, no, it's a very big role, no, and responsibility para sa atin,
mm-hmm,
para mabigyan natin ng solusyon. Kahit konting solusyon, no, at least malunasan natin, mabigyan natin ng lunas ang sa problema. So sa atin po, ma'am, sa pagbibigay po natin ng advocacy, ma'am, how is the response po, ma'am, ng ating mga tao? Is it the positive or negative
majority
response?
Majority of our advocacy.
Yes po.
Yeah, going back to health teaching, no, health advocacy, I'll just base it sa hospital setting.
Yes,
no? Nasa ano yan eh, nagbibigay ng health teaching. Kasi on my part, no, modesty aside, hindi ko sila iniiwanan.
Yes.
I'm not, hindi lang ako kontento na nabigay ko na, nagawa ko na yung trabaho ko. I really see to it that talagang naiintindihan nila. Kasi, useless lang yung ano yung ginagawa mong health teaching na hindi naman nila naiintindihan.
Wala naman
yun. So, yun lang talaga yung importante doon. You really have to impart it sa client mo na talagang na sigurado
nila.
Na nakuha nila yun. So, in the long run, sila na mismo, as I've said no kanina, na para sila naman din ang magiging health advocate.
As an agent change.
Yes. Kasi, mahirap eh, konti lang talaga yung ano mga health workers ngayon.
Tama po.
So, yun na, yung ginagawa kong trabaho, talagang hinuhone ko sila, in-equip ko sila, na sila mismo makatulong sa mga ano health workers. Para kung let's say, doon sila sa remote or rural area, para sila naman makakatulong, kahit in their, ano ba, small way.
Yes.
So, yun, that's why, yun lang talaga yung fulfillment ko, na talagang, maibigay ko tapos mapakita nila sa akin na intindihan nila and through that rest assured na naintindihan nila ma-impart din nila sa constituent nila.
Okay, ma'am, maraming salamat. I would also like to address the question back to Dr. In general po sa experience nyo lang working in Zamboanga City Medical Center, anong nakita niyong major challenges sa unit ninyo? And then, ano-anong kailangan sa tingin niyo dapat i-improve na ini-air to sa government itself para at least maano natin to, mahanapan natin ng magandang platform, yes, solution.
Correct.
To address this concern.
Sa amin kasi sa Zamboanga City Medical Center is the only tertiary referral center. So, lahat ng mga medyo toxic, medyo problematic na cases, doon na pupunta.
Okay.
Problema talaga namin, patient load.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi marami talaga kaming pasyente. So, right now, nagsastruggle talaga. Kaya nga sabi namin, it's easy for people to say na hindi nyo ginagawa ang trabaho nyo.
Mm-hmm.
It's easy for you to judge me unless you walk in my shoes.
Exactly.
So, we always tell people, you think it's what we're doing is easy? Come mm-hmm. and join me. Isang 24 hours lang.
Exactly.
Duty.
Exactly.
You will change the way you think. Yes. Oo. So, meron tayong mga estudyante noon, may mga clerks, may mga doktor na who will have, in my experience, no, we have lunch at midnight. Mm-hmm. Ganun ang lunch namin.
Grabe, no?
Oo, minsan hindi ka na magbe-breakfast kasi may endorsement na yon. Sometimes, yung mga 36 hours, hindi matutulog, hindi kakain. Kasi, you have to serve, you have to
ask. Yes.
Hindi yan nakikita ng ating community. Ang nakikita lang nila, grumpy yung doktor. Siyempre, hindi pa nakakain yan.
Hindi pa nakatulog.
Oo. One time, sinabihan ako ng pasyente, doktor, kanina pa ako gutom, doktor, sabi niya sa akin. Hindi pa ako kumakain ng lunch. Sabi ko, ma'am, ako ma'am, kahapon pa ako kumain. Kahapon pa ako kumain, ma'am. So, it's a two-way street, you know.
Yes.
So, kami, ang problema talaga namin, marami talagang patients. And when you have so many patients, you, syempre, masestretch din.
Mm-hmm.
Although ngayon, dumadami naman ang staff namin, but again, it's still not enough.
Yes.
It's still not enough. Because as your bed capacity increases, tumataas din yung staffing pattern mo. Mm-hmm. Pero yung standard staffing pattern, for example, nasa 500 bed capacity kami. Pero yung admissions namin, mga 700, mga ganyan,
dami.
600 plus,
dami. Yes.
Mga 130% capacity kami. Ang maganda sa hospital, nasa about 80% capacity yan because that allows you to clean your beds, prepare the beds, disinfect, mga ganyan. We don't have the luxury of that kasi mm-hmm. nga masyadong maraming patients.
So ano yung effect nito, Doc, sa inyo, part sa staffing natin na kung kulang talaga yung mga worker sa especially sa center, ano pa yung pwede may dulot nito na negative para sa inyo, effect nito?
Siyempre, hindi mo na sir mabigay yung full
good quality.
You can give service but sometimes the service is not yung sabi natin 100% kasi for example sa ward 1, no, yung OB guy ni department namin, minsan mga admissions nila mga 50. Tapos dalawang nurse lang yan.
Oh, Lord.
So, in fact, one of our unsung heroes itong mga nurses namin.
Mm, tama, tama.
Pagpasok niyan nila sa hospital in the morning, medyo ano pa yan, mabango-bango pa yan at naka-lipstick-lipstick pa yan.
Yes.
Pero at the end of the shift niyan, pag ano yan, frazzled na talaga yung mga buhok niyan, left and right, wala na home.
Unkempt
na yan, hindi na nakain, grumpy na yan. So, kasi there are just so many patients.
Yes. Tama yan.
Sabi nga namin, minsan sa emergency room, mas marami pang doktor kaysa sa nurses. So, that's also a limitation. Kasi nga, ang staffing pattern ng nurses is limited lang din.
Yes.
Oo. And they are, I cannot say enough of the fine work that our nurses do. They are just so overstretched.
Yes.
Yun na nga po.
Kaya yung nangyari sa Mabuhay, parang sa municipality namin, nakapunta kami ni partner Alin. Kasi yung mga nurses doon, alam mo, mga beauty pa eh, no? Beauty.
In the morning.
Iba dala, yung single pa talaga. Pa ibang
sila.
May asawa na.
Mm.
Pero imagine mo naman, kahit rocky road, kahit yung, kahit wavy na siya, pero andun pa rin sila. Kaya, napapasalamat kami na their presence talagang, kahit gaano kalayo, andun pa rin sila.
Pero, it's sa communities, it's not just the, it's not just the rocky roads, mm-hmm. no? Like for example, kasi ako I have experience in both public health and curative health sa hospital. So sa Serios Menya, sa Model Norte, yung time when I was working there, very active ang NPA.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So ang ating mga health workers, yung pumupunta sa mga bukid, they are also risking their lives.
Exactly.
Yes.
Tama po.
Pagdating ko doon, after 2 weeks, you know, 2 weeks pa lang ako doon, meron kaaga ko, agad akong medico-legal na gunshot wound sa inambush ng NPA.
Oh my God.
And that is where our midwives are going. So, pati buhay, they're putting their lives on the line.
Grabe.
Doc, Ken, pwede ba natin malaman? You mentioned about public health and curative health. So, on the grassroots, ano tong kaibahan? Para mas maintindihan nila.
Yes.
So, yung public health, or usually basically primary health ang tawag namin nito. Okay. Primary health, yun yung mga promotive, yung sa community. No? Okay. Yung mga tumitingin, first responders, na nag-health teaching sa communities, how to live healthy lives, how to prevent illness. Sila rin yung first contact.
Okay.
Now, yung curative, yun yung mga hospitals. Although may curative component din ang public health. Mm-hmm. Yung mga health centers, may mga doctor tumitingin, nagbibigay ng medication.
Yes.
But the concept of the grassroots is really promotion of health and prevention of illness.
Yes.
Ang hospitals natin is the one responsible for curative. Okay. So, yung mga operation, mm-hmm, chemotherapy, mga ganun. The costing, yun yung issue, isa sa mga issues ngayon.
Exactly po.
It's very expensive to maintain hospitals.
Exactly.
Yes.
The equipments are very expensive, mga ganyan. So far, ang budgeting natin has always been shift towards curative.
Okay.
Pero right now, as from my understanding, is nababalance out na because of the sin tax law.
Yes.
Medyo meron na rin tayong income nag-i-improve na rin ang ating public health. At the same time, yung PhilHealth natin, mm-hmm, merong capitation funds na bumabalik sa mga rural health units. So nakakatulong din 'yan. But again, it's not perfect.
Yeah,
it's not, yes, but something is happening already.
Okay. Doc, would you mind me to ask this question again? Knowing na may mga tao, based on our experience to working on the field, maririnig ka ding mga pasyente na nako-complain yan, kahit babalik-balik lang yung disease nila. So, there are growing numbers right now na we're into mga supplementation. Alam ko, aware po kayo, like na herbal products. Mm-hmm. They're going out. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So, yung pharmaceutical kasi ngayon, medyo naano na rin yung mga tao, ito lang ba ba ang ibinibigay? So, I would am led to ask you this question personally, like, are our doctors in the public institution like Zamboanga City Medical Center, for that matter, are they open for alternative healing? Yung mga like therapies involving the use of herbal products and other modalities like transpharmaceutical sciences and adjunctive therapy. Open po ba ang mga doctors natin dyan?
Ang usual na comment ko in terms of herbal medications and alternative medications, syempre, you cannot avoid, no? Kasi kami, our training is Western medicine.
Exactly po. Tama.
So sa amin is, sige, if you want to drink your herbals, just make sure that you take your
meds. Yeah.
Kasi yung medications, kasi dumaan siya sa process. Mm, so that process starts from the discovery of the active ingredient, itetest mo pa yan,
exactly,
animal
yes
studies, human
tama
studies.
Po. Yes.
And then after that, meron kang result. Mm-hmm. Pwede kang mag-attribute na ito yung mangyayari sa kanya.
Okay.
Some of our herbal medications do not pass through that.
Okay.
That is why they are called supplements.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko sa patient, kung kayo po ay mayaman talaga, ma'am, sir, at kaya ninyong bumili ng medications nyo and your supplements, why not? Take
okay
it. That's
okay
your, but kung konti lang ang pera natin, which is the majority of the people in
yes
the Philippines, edi doon na lang tayo kaya sa merong effect.
Mm-hmm.
Na scientifically proven to have an effect. When you say scientifically proven, hindi scientific yung sinasabing, ako po ay uminom nito at ako'y gumaling. Hindi
yun,
po yun. That is called
pass clinical test.
That is called, that is the lowest form of evidence.
Yes.
Yung tinatawag naming anecdotal. Kasi meron tayong tinatawag na placebo effect.
Mm, tama po.
Yung placebo effect, kahit walang laman yung pill at sinabi mong medicine ito, 10 to 20% of them will feel better,
yes,
taking that pill with nothing at all. Yan ang placebo mm effect. So, it comes into effect din yun sa yung anecdotals.
Opo.
So, kami, we would like to stick, no? Pero syempre, wala naman tayong control sa tao.
Mm.
So, ang advocacy lang namin is, take your meds. Mm-hmm. And then if you have extra money, then by all means, if you really want to, just be careful because sometimes not all herbal is good.
Exactly.
And not all supplements are good. For example, meron tayong mga supplements galing sa Malaysia. Okay. No? Take ng mga tao, they feel good, nawawala yung sakit daw, and then parang tumataba daw sila.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi nila alam, yung drink na yun, Sehat Badan ang pangalan.
Mm-hmm.
Sinuri ng mga ano natin, meron palang steroids yun.
Mm, okay.
Kaya pala yung nag-i-improve ang ano nila, wala lang sakit kasi it's immunomodulatory.
Yes.
Pero nasira na palang kanilang mga adrenal glands, nagkakaproblema na sila, nabubulag na, kakaroon siya ng Cushing syndrome, yung
apa.
Basta it was really bad. So not all herbal is good.
Apa.
Not all natural is good.
But if these products pass the clinical test, example, may mga researches talaga, clinical studies ginawa, are the doctors open for it now? Kasi nagiging trend yan ngayon, Doc. I mean, sa dami-daming mga pharmacia nandyan, na pumapasok, hindi natin maiwasan na meron talagang mga sales na ganun. Pero we just wanted, ang purpose natin, why I'm asking you this, is because we also wanted to know on the level of the doctors, if this has, you know, they have clinical studies that were proven to be very effective in it, open ba ang, let's say, kasi sa dami, as you mentioned, ang dami-daming pasyente araw-araw, kaya ba natin i-meet yung requirement na yun to serve? So, some people, kung nakikita nila, hindi na gaano na makapag-stretch pa ng time ang doctor, they would succumb for alternative medicine.
Yes.
Pero yun ang punto nyo, iklaro natin sa mga nakikinig na kahit mag-take sila ng anong supplementation, as long as nandyan pa rin ang piniscribe ng doctor.
Siguro,
importante yun.
I cannot speak for others, sir.
Yes,
I can only speak for my practice.
Yes.
Kasi, of course, I always try to let them take their medications first and foremost. Kasi sabi ko, meron ka talagang studies that prove. Of course, sabi nila, Doc, hindi siya nagwe-work. So, ang medications, hindi nagwe-work for... There are many issues kung bakit hindi nagwe-work either.
Yes.
Kulang ang dosage mo... yung time kailan ka mag-take,
Opa.
Yung mga ganun. So there are many issues about that. Pero as much as possible, we want them to focus the resources on the essentials.
Tama po.
Kung sobra-sobra naman ang pera nila that gusto nilang bumili, that is their own personal choice.
Why not?
Huh?
And wala na kaming magawa doon. Our job is to advocate for the use of scientifically proven.
Okay. At least nalino to ngayon.
Yes, nama yung partner.
Kasi maraming tao on the grassroots, ang tingin nila ngayon, pag binibigay lang itong ganito, walang ebidensya, they feel frustrated. Kasi we have heard all of this.
So dami kasi pumapasok.
Yes.
Na hindi natin alam.
Yes. But anyway, sige, at least open pa rin po kayo sa mga ganong ano. On one condition, sabi nyo, basta prescribed, nandun pa rin, mini-maintain. Second, kung meron silang extra, why not? Tama po. Why not?
Yun. Well,
but to impose yung sinasabi na, halimbawa, magte-take sila ng supplements in exchange, palitan yung piniscribe ninyo, it's, I think siguro yun ang mali doon.
Yeah, we have many patients na sa Doc, nag-stop na ako kaya nag-take ako nitong...
Yes, product.
Product.
Okay.
Sabi ko, ba't kayo nandito ngayon, ma'am? Ba't puputulan na natin ang paa ninyo ngayon?
Hindi yes. Ng puno.
Oh, kasi, like, there are some, this is a treatment for asthma, pneumonia, TB, cancer. So, lahat-lahat na ba?
Yes.
Siya daw ang sagot. Naririnig na natin sa radyo yan. No? Take yes. This herbal
yes,
supplement.
Yes, yes.
Sakit sa asthma, breast
yes.
Cancer, pneumonia.
Lahat
sabi
na.
Ko, ano yan, Diyos? Na nasasagot niya lahat.
Yes.
Pero ang mga tao natin kasi, yung bang power of anecdotes, anecdotal evidence, so, narinig nila, nakakalakad na ngayon. So, or wala na, nakakabasa na ako kahit wala akong glasses. Well, so anyway, yun ang gusto ninyo. Take nyo, but again, eventually, babalik lang po kayo sa amin.
Yes.
Oo.
Yan din ang dahilan kung bakit we wanted, para yung concept, misconception na yan, ma-address natin ng maayos.
Marami talaga kaming Opo. Cases sa Zamboanga City Medical Center na, especially mga diabetic food, no?
Opo.
Take sila ng herbals. Okay na ako, Doc, okay na ako. Ma'am, puputulan na natin ang paa ninyo.
Yes.
Paano yun, di ba? So, ngayon ang medications for diabetes available siya sa health centers natin. We can give them. Okay. Why do we need to take herbals? Na mahal din. Hindi man mura ang mga herbals. Yes. Yung isang herbal, hindi ko na i-mention, baka masupa ako. Yes, 16 pesos, 3 times a day pa pinapatake. Mm. Eh, for example, yung metformin, libre lang sa health center. Kung bibili mo man, parang 3 piso lang ata isa. So, for the price of one of that herbal, eh, mawatake mo na ng 2 days ang metformin mo. Eh, bakit pa tayo pupunta doon? So, yun yung point namin.
Pero, Doc, pwede natin naman siguro, ano, no? If, ano kayang mangyari kapag sabayan siya? Ano kaya sa tingin yung magiging impact? Magandang product sa herbal, example lang. At may mga other products din siya. Tapos sasabayin niya yung products ng ano po, pharmaceutical.
Meron kasi siya tawag na, sir, na substance to substance interaction or drug to drug interaction. So kung hindi siya nasuri in terms of that, hindi natin alam ang interaction niya. So, possible man to take them together, something might happen, something might not happen. So, hindi tayo. But there is the concept of drug-to-drug interaction. Yes. So, kamamaya tinik mo, mas nag-worsen or mas nag-improve ka, mga ganun. So, it has to be studied first bago maano siya. Kasi, yun yung fear. Meron din kaming tinatawag niya idiosyncratic reaction.
Okay.
Hindi mo ma-predict na lalabas siya.
Lalabas siya.
Oh, so, pwede din ganun. So,
may mga terms din kayong naririnig na sinasabi nilang Herzheimer's reaction or healing crisis na kapag pumasok doon itong product na to pinalalabas as a result of detoxification. Pero ewan ko lang ba, Doc. But what I am certain right now is at least from your end, naririnig namin na hindi naman sa pala talaga negative na ano natin. Kasi ang,
for me, sir. Oh, yes, no, for me. I cannot speak for the general medical community.
Ah, okay.
This is my own personal. Ano. Kasi baka mamaya sabihin na may ibang doktor. Hindi naman yan ang view namin. Sa'yo lang yan. So let me give a disclaimer. This is just my own personal opinion.
Pero pag ang product may sinabing adjunctive therapy, pumapayag po ba ang mga authorities katulad nyo?
So far, sir, I mean, more of ano pa rin kami, yung medications namin.
I see. Mm. Okay. But anyway, sige partner, may gusto ka pang ano, itanong. Okay.
Yes.
We barely have almost 22 minutes more to go. Now that you have heard our doctor speak about the advocacy of health education, do not forget to stay tuned with us every Saturday on our new time slot schedule from 3 o'clock to 4:30 in the afternoon as we update you with the best information on health education, life coaching, learning opportunities towards holistic empowerment and livelihood program. We are one in the hope of witnessing one success and the birth and championing of our Filipino dreams worldwide through Hello Health. So, Doc, any last words or inspiration or message na gusto nyong ipashare sa ating mga tagapakinig?
Siguro, what we would like to tell people is to take responsibility.
Okay, Pa.
Responsibility for health, responsibility for environment, responsibility for our future. Hindi pwedeng trabaho nila yan. Trabaho ng gobyerno yan. Trabaho ng ganyan. Hindi. Dapat ikaw mismo magsabi, gagawin ko to kasi it is my responsibility. I think the Filipino has up the potential to make a difference. Tama Hindi ba po. Tayo napapagod na ganito na lang tayo palagi?
Tama po.
Hindi ba tayo napapagod na palagi na lang natin naririnig na iniinsulto tayo ng mga ibang bansa, mababa ang tingin nila sa atin? When will we start and, you know, have pride in our own self, in our capacity as a nation?
Opo.
So, we can do that by taking charge, being responsible for our own future. Hindi yan lahat kaya ng gobyerno. Gawa din tayo ng part natin in nation building.
Tama po.
And what about Ma'am? May last word po ba tayo sa mga nakikinig?
For me, no, sana naman lahat ng mga health providers, no, those who are conducting health education, health teaching, sana naman they really have to put their heart on it.
Yes.
No? So that hindi lang yan na makatulong tayo sa ibang tao. It's also for ourselves na kulang na nga tayo. So with their help, malaking scope na maitutulong nila.
kung sila mismo ang magiging health advocates. And wow, thank you for that.
Yes. Actually, nakikita ko na ang malakihan at matagalang ano partnership dito, partner.
Correct, partner.
Kasi I know na they have been doing kudos to our guests for this afternoon kasi sa dami nilang ginagawa at noble na masyado. Hindi lang natin alam ang stress level nila.
Yes,
kaya tanungin ko nga sana, Doc, paano na lang kaya kung laging stress at ang doctor at nurse?
Paano lang kaya?
Anong mangyayari? How do you balance or how do you deal with real stress?
Yes.
Bago po kami magano, gusto namin, ano yung mga effective strategies ninyo para ma-overcome nyo itong, alam namin, sobrang ano eh, challenging yun.
Sa amin naman sa Zamboanga City Medical Center, kami sa public health, hindi kami as stressful mm-hmm. as the clinical areas. Yung sa clinical areas, yung tumitingin talaga ng pasyente, ER, mga wards, OR, sila po talaga yung under a lot of stress. So, sila yung mga heroes natin. Siguro, ang hingi lang namin is a little thank you, a little appreciation for us. Kasi masyadong, ika nga sabi natin, judgmental ang tao. Akala nila walang ginagawa yung ating mga nurses and mga doctors and all the people in CCMC. We're just exerting patience. We're just, you know, kasi wala ka naman magawa kung magalit ka, mag-respond ka, iraradyo ka, o ano, ko-complain ka, ganyan. So, they are really suffering. And in fact, you know, the pay is not that high, especially for the nurses. Kasi syempre, pag abroad ka, laki ng sweldo.
Yes.
Pero dito, they're just, you know, we're just trying to make a little easy for them, you know, making relaxation, mga ganyan. Kung may mga hospital week kami, may mga masahe-masahe kami, wow, may mga show-shows kami, mga ganyan. But again, it's not enough. There's a lot of stress and anxiety among our staff and mm-hmm. it cannot be avoided because of the number, but it can be lessened by simple appreciation of a thank you and a smile. Wow. In the morning.
Yes. And Doc, since we know that there are lots of mga nurses and doctors andun sa abroad, no, and aling message natin sa kanila, Doc, no, sa mga kasi alam natin may mga magagaling talaga, yes, ng mga doktor.
Actually, gusto ko, yes, pa nga siyang tanungin, yeah, bakit hindi kayo nag-abroad? That's a personal point.
Hindi naman natin sila ma-prevent, yes, kasi mm-hmm. that is their right. And sometimes sabi nila, you want a better future for your family. So, we have to respect that. Yes. We have nothing against them. Yung mga katulad namin, siguro kontento na ba kami sa what we have right here? We may not earn as much as them, but the concept again of social wealth. Here, we have the opportunity to earn so much social wealth.
Okay, that's good.
So that's
at least na confirm nyo po galing sa inyo affirmation yun na we have so much to actually unveil yung social wealth thing na yun. And that's it, ma'am. I think baka ano po rin po, bakit hindi kayo umalis? Hindi kayo nag-abroad.
Sa ilang taon na nag-servisyo sa government, and bakit walang idea na pupunta nang abroad, and alam natin ng malaking sahod doon, no?
Yes, tama. Sige, po, ma'am. Tama po.
Actually, no, I'm so blessed to have a good family. Even my children, they're registered nurses.
Wow.
And
okay,
they
po
prefer to,
yes,
stay here.
Yes.
Kasi just ano, tama na yung simple living, mm-hmm. yung ano salary na tatanggap, it's much enough. Mm-hmm. So why bother to go out?
Okay. So,
ako, honest, I'm really very ano contented dito lang.
Wow. Apo.
Yung gandang passion yun, no?
Yun talagang, nga po eh.
Talagang for Filipino.
Tama po. Pro Filipino, at mas kailangan natin sila dito.
Yes, definitely.
Oh, yun nga. Now that thank you very much once again, Dr. Kunting and Ma'am Bunag, for your precious time and for the knowledge and wisdom that you have shared, and we've learned a lot from you today. Isa pong bagay na pinaka-ano namin, kasi this episode brings a lot,
yes,
of ideas for people to reflect upon.
Correct.
Lalong-lalo na yung concept na natuto ako ngayon sa kanya, mumula kay Dr. Kunting. We have so much to discover about social wealth.
So, social wealth.
I will be reflecting on that. Paano ko ita-translate ng maayos to sa darating na ano, darating na panahon. So before we get to say goodbye, after barely having 5 minutes more to go, allow us to share with you the message for from our heart for this afternoon, partner, I think ikaw talaga yung lagi kong inaatasan.
Yes.
Okay.
Anyway,
share natin yan.
Sige. So, yes, partner, no, for this episode, we share the words of BKS Iyengar, which says, health is a status of complete harmony of the body, mind, and spirit. When one is free from physical disabilities and mental destructions, the gates of the soul open. Balikan ko para at least marinig ng
expound ko rin
yan.
Okay.
Sabi dito, no, health is a state of complete harmony of the body, mind, and spirit. When one is free from physical disabilities and mental destructions, the gates of the soul open. So, ika nga, no? So, when it comes to health, talagang napaka-importante ang health sa ating katawan.
Mm-hmm.
Dahil ito yung nagbibigay ng lakas, nagbibigay ng saktong or wastong pag-iisip sa atin.
Mm-hmm.
At pwede nating gawin ang bagay-bagay. And when it comes to relate it to God, no?
Yes.
And this quote talagang with similarities to God, no? Talagang kung inaccept natin ang Diyos sa katawan
exactly.
natin, no? It's like similar to health.
The miracle healer.
Oh, yes. Miracle healer. Kung talagang kilala mo siya at you receive him sa atin, sa buhay natin, then the gate is open. I mean, open for all of us, no? For those believers. Sa lahat po nakikinig, no? So we have to open our minds and hearts.
Yes.
No? And for us, no, and our soul to be free, not to be free to heaven.
Okay, tama po. On a macro level, lahat naman ng aspeto sa buhay, partner.
Yes.
Pag hindi maganda yung synergy diyan.
Correct.
Mahirap. Kasi isang absence lang ng isang factor na yun, damay ang lahat.
The domino effect. So kailangan magkaroon ng collaboration.
Yes. Kaya nga po this program also brings about yung mga the best ideas possible for people to be more educated. Kasi as we said, we're not here to compete.
No, yes.
There's no competition among us. But
yes.
We are here to complete or complement one another because ang ginagawa ni doctor at saka ni ma'am sa field, isang bagay na talagang kahanga-hanga.
Correct.
But what we can do the most as well is to also help people to be more educated kasi limitado ang oras nila. Hindi sila pwedeng mag-field work. Kaya ito yung point natin. We would be bringing more partners in the advocacy to make sure that we will enrich the passion. Buti nga si Doc hindi umalis to kasi kawala na naman siguro ng magaling nandito
yes.
pa sa Pilipinas.
Kaya yung pinag-usapan natin last time, di ba? Na paano lang kaya kung wala ng mga magagaling na mga doctor,
mm-hmm.
nurses,
ano lang mangyari
sa
atin?
What will happen?
Manatili na lang ang mga ang magtuturo daw sa mga bata, yung mga yaya na lang.
Yaya na lang.
Oh, wala na yung magagaling eh. So
wala
once
na.
Again, I'm very happy and fortunate to have you on as our guest for this first month anniversary namin. And we look forward na we will have more partnerships to come. Especially, alam namin yung advocacy ninyo, napakaganda po. And so, have a wonderful Saturday. Everyone, do not forget that for a healthy self, heal thyself po. Kasi doon po nagsisimula. So, God bless you more. And once again, this is your buddy and friend on the line. I am Alain A. Paragas with Dr. Afdal Kunting and Ma'am Bunag. And with partner Jason C. Mahinay saying, in moments of healing, learning, sharing, and wealth building, sabi nga, social wealth, the term I coined from Dr. Kunting. It's
Hello Health!
That the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt. Who am I that the bright and morning star would choose to light the way for my ever wandering heart? Well, not because of who I am, but because of what you've done,
ay dahil lang sa'yo, sa'yo'y mawawala, kulang ang aking buhay. pagmamahal mong taglay. Ang dami kong dasal, pag-ibig ay magtatagal. Iingatan natin sa habang buhay. Pagkakailangan ko ang isang katulad mo na nagmamahal sa akin ng tunay.
This is Against the Flow on 702 DZAS.
Christian Bautista, and I am going against the flow.
Hi, I'm Barbie Almalbisanasan, and I go against the flow.
Hi, I'm Azel Van Omen, and I go against the flow.
Hi, I'm Tony Gonzaga, and I go against the flow.
Hi guys, it's me, Danita Rose, and I want you guys to be like me and go against the flow.
Hi, I'm Alex Compton, and I go against the flow.
It's Michael Turner. I want to encourage you all to keep going against the flow.
This is John from Fire Fall Down, and I go against the flow.
Hi, I'm Paolo Valenciano, and I go against the flow.
Ako po si Yung Constantino, and I go against the flow.
Gary, going against the flow. I'm challenging you to go against the flow too.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Against the Flow with me, Jordan. And today, it's going to be a very special episode. Remember about those guys I told you about will be coming to the Philippines? Well, they're here, as in right now. Please welcome on the program, Christofari.
Hey, how you doing? Good, good, good to be here.
Yeah, well, that's Mark Moore. He's Christofari.
I am today.
But welcome back to the Philippines.
Thanks so much, man. It's a privilege. It's been 5 years since we've been here last, and that was our first time, so it's good to be back.
And welcome back, Justin.
Hey.
All right, we got some other guys here. Mark, who's with you this time? They're not around right now because they're knocked out, jet lagging and all that, but who is with you on this trip?
Well, we've got 8 people on the stage. Alex is here in the room. Alex, say hi.
What's up, everybody?
And Justin is in the room, and then beyond that, my wife. We have, and then we also have Nikita, we have Daniel, Samuel, and Times, and then our crew. And you're a part of our crew now, dude. You're officially in the band.
Oh, wow, yes. I am their porter and bouncer and spokesperson. Yeah. So anyways, Mark, welcome back again. It's nice to see you guys here in the country again. It's been 5 years already, and the last time I had you on the program, this used to be called Perfect Rhythm. But now, welcome to Against the Flow.
Yeah, I like it. ATF.
So what are you guys doing here in the Philippines this time?
Well, you know, Philippines is a place that is dear to our heart. We've had band members that were born here in the past, and it was the first place we went as a full band missions trip on our own. And it really kind of set us on a new trajectory. Last time we were here, we ministered in Smoky Mountain and Women's Prison. And it just kind of made us more missional. And from then on, we've just had that mindset. So now we're coming back more so as seasoned missionaries and less as an international band on a tour, though it's a bit of both.
So if you guys missed it, they call themselves musicianaries. And I guess their moments here back then, that was their baptism of fire.
And it was hot. It was hot in some of the places we went.
So that's when you just started going places with or without a proper setup or money involved. Yeah. Or, you know, usually, let me explain real quick to the listeners. When you get these international bands over to your country, the way it works is, well, you have a contract, you sign it after you go through all the restrictions and lawsuits and whatever is on that, and come up with a money that they would accept, and then you take care of hotel, food, and then make sure every single part of their technical rider is met. Only then will they come. Now, you guys are against the flow.
We're against the flow, yeah.
You do it the other way around.
Well, here's my philosophy. My philosophy is I can't imagine Jesus saying, okay, yeah, Matthew's going to be the one collecting the honorarium. Actually, no, Judas will handle the contract. And if you want the disciples, it's going to cost more and this and that. I mean, you know, I'm all about not muzzling an ox as they're trotting, but we don't do this as an industry standard. We try and do it as a ministry standard. And so for us, our goal is to reach the lost at any cost. And that means we're going to make sacrifices and to make disciples of all nations. And that means we're going to have to go to places that can't afford to bring us out. There's a few places that could afford to bring us out. And we did that for the first 20 years of our ministry. But for the last 9 years, we've been really focusing more so on the places that can't afford to bring us out. And what we would require back in the old days, that's like a Filipino pastor's salary for a whole year. And now we're just saying whatever God puts on your heart. And sure, they don't give us much, but we don't come for that.
And it's been working. You guys are live. you have your limbs intact, yeah, and all that.
Yeah.
So congratulations. Thanks. So again, when I said these guys go against the flow, the way it works is 1 or 2 months ago, I get message from Mark and company saying, hey, we might drop by there, we might not. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, what do we do? And they're like, well, do you have any events? And then I'm like, I introduced to you our event, mm-hmm, at Gen Con called Rock the Walk. And then before I even tell them anymore, they booked the ticket already.
Yeah, we just booked it in faith.
And so I'm like, uh-oh, how long are you staying? And they're like, over 9 days, something like that. And so I'm like, well, do you need other places to go? And they say, yes. And you got anyone to help you? And, of course, the last guy, shout outs to Jason. He's in another country right now.
Yeah. So you're the man.
So, yes, I volunteered for it. And now I'm taking you around wherever.
Which is great. And we're just so grateful for it. And you guys don't just have an awesome radio host here, but he's a genuine man of God with a pastor's heart and a servant's spirit.
So I could be the host with the most.
You're the host with the most.
I'm a host on the radio, hosts in food and lodging or whatever. Anyways, Mark, let's check into a song. Let's get the listeners some of your music. What do we got here?
Well, I think it'd be good for us to start off with one of our more popular songs. It's called Hosanna. Last time we came here, I got really sick, so I got really skinny by the end of the tour, which meant that come the music video, I was looking pretty good.
That's how you do it.
That's how we do it. I had some roadside food that I shouldn't have had. But, Hosanna is our, hands down, our most popular video. I think it's our most popular song of all time. Last I checked, we're at about 9 million, and I think that about at least 500,000 of those views are from Philippines. So let's listen to it right now. This is Hosanna from our reggae worship album.
And I must say, this is the best reggae version I've heard of it.
Amen.
Christ the Fire, I hear on Against the Flow. We'll be back with more of Mark Moore.